It brings to the table again the issues of when you talk about requirement, it then comes to the issue of experience. In what capacity have you led to the extent that you want to lead?
I have
180 million Nigerians.
I have been able to run a company in Nigeria successfully, and this is one of the things that many people that you have today in leadership, current president of Nigeria, has not done. So if you are looking for experience of how to create jobs, I have it. If you are looking for experience of how to be able to inspire the people of this country to build the kind of the nation that they want for themselves, I have it. If you are looking for somebody that can speak to Nigerians and tell them that this is the role that you are expected to play as a people, and this is the role that the government is expected to play, and I will lead that, I have the capacity to do
because
that.
Being a president is a slice of being solid in terms of being a good policy and governance oriented person, and a slice of being a politician. So in terms of being a politician, how much of that do you have?
I don't want to go into the political discussions of how much political experience I have, but how much experience am I bringing to the table to solve the problem of this?
Let's talk about some of your plans. You are of the Action Democratic Party.
Absolutely.
What's the vision of your party for the number one job in the country?
We want to create an inclusive government that works for everybody. We are a social democrat team. We want to have a nation that is driven by Nigerians. We want to have a country that is owned by the citizens of this country, not a country that is owned by a few people in government. And basically, that is the stand of Action Democratic Party. So our focus is in being able to ensure that every single person on the streets of this country is able to feel the impact of governance. I always ask people, what do you think are the dividends of being a citizen of Nigeria? Most of them have nothing. So what we want to do is to offer the citizens of this country some sense of hope for them to be able to see for themselves that yes, we are able to have a government that is responsible and is able to work for them.
Mr. Sado, you say you're a social democrat.
Yes, sir.
In the first 100 days in office, should you be elected as president of Nigeria, what would you do?
In the first 100 days of my administration, we would have been able to call all our bilateral and multilateral arrangements with other nations and review all of them to implement a kind of economic system I call Make in Nigeria, MIN. Well, how do you have a nation, a society that has over 200 million people, and almost 90% of the things that we use in that country are being imported? And these are being imported by countries that are supposed to be our friends. Why are we not discussing with them to say, you know what, you cannot continue to come to our country to dump these things, but come to our nation to build these things
for
us?
In terms of quota, importation and exportation quota, what is your vision?
What I want to do is to reduce it to almost 90%. That we should begin to produce the things that we need, 90% of the things we need, from cars.
Local production?
Yes, from cars to pencils to every single thing that we need.
But that cannot be derived That's what I say.
We'll start the process that, and this economic policy is one of the things that I've been talking about.
So if you are talking about social democracy, you're talking about welfareism.
Yeah.
You're talking about jobs. You're talking about the middle class. What exactly is your plan in creating jobs?
Now, make in Nigeria economic policy has the capacity to create millions of jobs, because all we need to have is to have industries that are currently producing these things for us outside and dumping them in our country, put them in Nigeria, for them to be the ones that will drive the job. For us to also have electricity, we need millions of people to work in that sector. We need, once you can have factories, for instance, Kaduna Textile. When Kaduna Textile was up, there were thousands of people that were employed there. Now we have
a modern textile technology in modern textile cloth making is different from what we have there.
Yeah, absolutely. We have virtually everything that we have.
Less manpower, more engineering,
but
more technology.
But again, once you are able to have all of these things being produced in your country, there is the resultant effect around that this creates. You have a situation where people who clean the offices, people who transport these things from one...
Because we're out of time, you mentioned something, that's the issue of electricity.
Yeah.
You know how to fix that?
Absolutely. This is what I do. That's what I do. I am into alternative electricity supply.
Basically, and that's what you were into.
Yes, this one. No, not really. But basically, what is the challenge with the electricity problem in the situation in Nigeria? Simple. The people that you have in government are not willing to solve the problem. They make the problem look complicated for them to look as though they are doing something. But if we can get ourselves ready, can elect me into the office, I can guarantee you that in less than 2 years, electricity in this country will begin to, you see results.
Mr. Mathias Sado is an engineer who wants to fix Nigeria if you elect him as the president. He's an aspirant under the platform of the Action Democratic Party. Thank you so much for talking to us on the channel, on the program tonight.
Thank you very much.
Well, up next on the program, electoral fraud, especially vote buying, seems to be a new headache for INEC election observers. So we ask, who is buying the votes?